The Third Day, Prophecies. Many passages of prophetic scripture are quickly passed over for want of plausible explanation. But occasionally, we stumble into an understanding that certainly the Holy Spirit providentially superintended. Number 3. It is the first of the four so-called perfect numbers. 3. Divine perfection. 7. Spiritual perfection. 10. Ordinal perfection. And 12. Governmental perfection. It is the glory of God to conceal a thing, but the honor of kings is to search out a matter. Proverbs 25:2.
Saying, the Son of Man must suffer many things, and be rejected of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be slain, and be raised the third day. It is the glory of God to conceal a thing, but the honor of kings is to search out a matter. The heaven.
Whether we feel ourselves entirely incapable of finding our right hand with our left, in matters of prophecy, or we feel ourselves to be sufficiently grounded, it is only the blessed Paraclete himself that can remove the scales from our eyes to make plain the meaning he intended when he inspired the writing of the prophecies.
Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come.
Ancestors ate manna in the desert, but they died. But the bread that comes down from heaven is of such a kind that whoever eats it will not die.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If you eat this bread, you will live forever. The bread that I will give you is my flesh, which I give so that the world may live.
This started an angry argument among them.
How can this man give us his flesh to eat? I am.
And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests, and an holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel. But now thy kingdom shall not continue. The Lord hath sought him a man after his own heart, and the Lord hath commanded him to be captain.
Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. And the Lord said unto Moses, Go unto the people, and sanctify them today and tomorrow, and let them wash their clothes, and be ready against the third day. For the third day, the Lord will come down in the sight of all the people upon Mount Sinai.
Always on the third day there seemed something happening.
Chapter 5. Now it came to pass on the third day that Esther put on her royal apparel and stood in the inner court of the king's house over against the king's house. And the king sat upon his royal throne in the royal house over against the gate of the house. And it was so, when the king saw Esther the queen standing in the court, that she obtained favor in his sight. And Joseph said unto them the third day, This do and live, for I fear God. And the earth brought forth grass, and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the third day. Then on the third day Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. And Abraham said unto his young men, Abide ye here with the ass, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship, and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering, and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father, and said, My father. And he said, Here am I, my son. And he said, Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? And Abraham said, My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering.
After 2 days will he revive us. In the third day he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight. Then shall we know if we follow on to know the Lord. His going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain, as the latter and former rain unto the earth. But, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day.
From Adam to Jesus is 4,000. From Jesus to his second coming is 2,000.
After 2 days will he revive us. In the third day he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight. Then shall we know if we follow on to know the Lord. His going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain, as the latter and former rain unto the earth.
What will happen when our Lord return, most do not know.
And I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands. And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years, but the rest of the dead lived not again until the 1,000 years were finished. This is the first resurrection. Blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such the second death hath no power, but they shall be priests of God and of Christ, and shall reign with him 1,000 years.
Nearly 2,000 years ago Christ died for us. He shall shortly come to take his bride home.
After 2 days will he revive us. In the third day he will raise us up, and we shall live in his sight. Then shall we know if we follow on to know the Lord. His going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain,
as the latter and former reign under the earth.
But, beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. And it came to pass that after 3 days they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, both hearing them and asking them questions.
Here is a shadow in Leviticus: on the 3rd day you sacrifice is not accepted, so also on the 3rd day Jesus, when he arrives, it is too late, there is no more sacrifice for sin, and you will bear your own iniquity.
And if any of the flesh of the sacrifice of his peace offerings be eaten at all on the 3rd day, it shall not be accepted, neither shall it be imputed unto him that offereth it. It shall be an abomination, and the soul that eateth of it shall bear his iniquity.
When Christ shall come, it is too late to give a peace offering unto God. And what is that peace offering? It is Christ our Redeemer, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. So today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart.
The time is coming. The time has already come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear it will come to life. Just as the Father is himself the source of life, in the same way he has made his Son to be the source of life. And he has given the Son the right to judge, because he is the Son of Man.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. For as the Father hath life in himself, so hath he given to the Son to have life in himself, and hath given him authority to execute judgment also, because he is the Son of Man. Marvel not at this, for the hour is coming, in the which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice, and shall come forth, they that have done good unto the resurrection of life, and they that have done evil unto the resurrection of damnation.